Immediately after World War II, the Soviets began to dominate the countries of Eastern Europe, both politically and economically. Communism in the Soviet Union meant that every aspect of people's lives was controlled by the state, and personal freedoms were virtually non-existent. Hoping that post-war Europe would develop according to the ideals of democracy and free enterprise, the U.S. greatly feared the spread of communism. In 1946, former British Prime Minister Winston Churchill warned America and the world that Soviet expansion would not stop at what he called the Iron Curtain, an imaginary line that separated the countries in Western Europe from the countries under Soviet domination in Eastern Europe. U.S. President Harry S. Truman was also worried about the spread of communism around the world and developed the Truman Doctrine, a policy of aiding nations threatened by communist uprisings. The object was not to defeat communism, but to keep it from spreading. This principle would later become known as the containment policy. In addition, in 1948, the U.S. implemented the Marshall Plan, named after Secretary of State George Marshall. It provided economic aid to the war-torn countries of Europe, including Germany.
The U.S. wanted to use its economic power to stimulate economic recovery in Western Europe, both out of a belief that this was a humanitarian thing to do to help these people recover from the war, but also out of a strategic belief that economic prosperity in Western Europe would be one way to prevent the triumph of communism in Western Europe.